Hello people, in the previous video we have discussed about the basic functionality of the internet and yet to discuss the role of internet service providers. If you had not checked that video, I suggest you to give a quick glance of it and come back to know about ISPs. The link is mentioned in the description. Hope you have got some basic understanding of the core functionality of internet through my previous video. So now, let's first discuss what are service providers. Every business provides services to their customers who buy their products. These services can be of any type, such as providing warranty, delivery, security, consulting, customer service, and technical support. Likewise, while we use internet, there are some entities called internet service providers, ISPs, who help us in getting different services of internet in different ways. In a nutshell, without the existence of ISPs, we cannot access the internet. For instance, to access the internet for our gadgets, we either use the mobile data provided by our SIM, such as Idea, Airtel, Jio, etc. or by the broadband networks like ActFiberNet, JioFiberNet, etc. So the one which you are subscribed to is known as your ISP. Along with providing the internet with the requested bandwidth, ISPs also provide the services like web page hosting, domain name registration, mail services, and file transfers, etc. They use different kind of technologies to provide internet to the different kind of users through modems, dial-ups, cable internet, wireless broadband, Wi-Fi internet, Ethernet, etc. They provide these services according to the demand of the users. For example, to the normal users in the small town or a city, ISPs provide internet services through DSL connection, cable mode connection, and Wi-Fi. But for businesses and large organizations, this is done through Ethernet, Metropolitan Ethernet, and frame relay services. As you have got the clear idea about what are ISPs and what they do, now let's understand the different categories of ISPs. There are namely three categories in ISPs: Tier 1 ISP, Tier 2 ISPs, and Tier 3 ISPs. Now, what are Tier 1 ISPs? They stand at the top in the hierarchy of ISPs. Tier 1 ISPs take care of installing the optical fiber cables under the sea and make sure to connect these cables to each and every country in the world. Hence, the major part of your internet subscription fee goes to the Tier 1 ISPs. The next one, Tier 2 ISPs. These ISPs operate under Tier 1 ISPs, making sure to distribute the network connectivity to the different states of the respective countries in which they operate. So while the Tier 1 ISPs provide internet to different countries of the world, Tier 2 ISPs provide internet to the different states in the country they operate. Coming to Tier 3 ISPs, these are the smallest ISPs which operate under Tier 2 ISPs, providing different internet services to the different cities, towns, villages, and colonies. Tier 3 ISPs access the internet from Tier 2 ISPs to redistribute them to every nook and corner of the colonies. Despite this hierarchy, there is no one called as the owner of the internet. It is just a medium which connects the different gadgets, and every user who uses the internet becomes an entity in this interconnected network. So I hope that you have got a clear walkthrough about what are ISPs, what kind of services they provide, and what are the different categories in them. After knowing this amazing historical journey, don't you wonder how we are able to access the wireless internet connectivity to all our gadgets at our home? That is all going to be covered in the coming video. Before you go, make sure you motivate me through liking the video and subscribing to my channel. Also check my blogging website mentioned in the description. Thank you for staying till the end. See you in the next video.